Hello YouTube, this is Optimus Smythe back for another video review, and as you can see today we're looking at a more recent figure, Dark of the Moon Voyager Class Megatron. He is so cool. Now I got this actually as a present from my cousin, and it's really awesome. The only thing is he's tiny, and you know what, I might as well just show you a size comparison right now. Look at how big Voyager Optimus is compared to him. He's huge. Like, look at how tiny he is. It's just not working at all. And, I mean, it's mainly because, see, Voyager Optimus doesn't have his trailer, so... Yeah, the first Voyagers were pretty big. These Dark of the Moon Voyagers were fairly small, and it's mainly probably because a lot of his size is being taken up by the whole tank and everything else back here. Yeah, his tarp just pretty much sits on there. You can't tab it into anything. It just pretty much... sits on top, which is kind of unfortunate. It looks cool being there, though. It's just it falls off so easily, see? In fact, I'll just take that off right now and show you. See how neat it is. I kind of touched up a little bit on this whole black thing with the spikes and everything. I made it a bit silvery. You know, you can't really tell. It's kind of rubbed off in some spots, but I did it on where the lights are going to be behind those bars. And these things down here and that and that. And it's cool because there's some rust markings here and there and in other places. It's not as movie accurate, though. There's a lot more spikes and knives coming out, even in this spot right here. It's a lot more rusty. It's got chains everywhere. Not exactly film accurate, but it works enough for me, I guess, except for the size. And you can kind of see his toes back here. That's what makes the tarp good to go there. And I like how this is right here because it allows you to take other mech tech port weapons and plug them on top. I love doing this with him. I think this is very sweet. And he's also got another port right here on the roof, one of those things that sinks in. You see the... Well, let's straighten this gun out. Always have to do that. See, that looks pretty sweet too, although I prefer it the other way. And then you can, if you want, take this out. This is his mech tech weapon, but that just kind of looks strange. Here's his gun. To use it, you take this out, and then here it is. This is the mech tech feature. I love that. I love this gun so much. It turns into some kind of claw type weapon. I'm trying to not talk when I'm doing it because it makes a lot of noise, and apparently this camera's so lame, it doesn't pick up too many noises at once. So, I can't talk while it's actually making the noise that this is going to happen, or that's going to happen, if you didn't hear me what I said. It's got 5 barrels, as you can see. It must be pretty powerful. It's more like a cannon. It's not his shotgun. And yeah, it can plug in top here, although it does kind of lean down a little bit. Now, let's transform him. His transformation's not that difficult. I'm going to do the hard part first, actually. You take these things and pull them down. Oh, and I forgot to show you that he can actually turn right back here at the end of the trailer part, or where it begins. And then you got to do the same with this one, although this one on my figure is harder to do. You pull it down. Then, while we're at it, might as well put these up and open this up with it and take the arms, kind of pull them out, and then bend them down. Same with the other one. And then, this whole black thing, I would just take that off if I were you, so then it's easier to just kind of pull this down, that the legs are bending back there, and kind of like pull it down. While you're pulling it down, this should kind of split apart like that. You can see his face there. Turn the arms down. Take these things, push them up, so that you can twist the arms forward, and then bring out the fingers right there. Now, on here... take this apart and put these back where they belong, and then spin them around, and there's a little hole right there which this will kind of like hook into like that, and then do the same with the other side. Yeah, it does make things easier if you take those pieces off, and then take this and the head should kind of come up on its own like that. Take this and just kind of like fit it in there like that, and then split these apart and angle them upwards. So we've got the whole upper body done. Let me put this off. Now down here, what you do is come here and split those in half. Split this down. Bring the legs down. There's a double joint here. Bring them down and out, and then turn his waist. Well, upper abdomen, I guess you could call it. Then take this crotch piece, put it in there. Take these wheels, and making sure that the thighs are straightened out, that it's not turning at the trailer, take these wheels
and bend them all the way in, so it'll keep the thighs from turning, and it just looks more realistic. Turn up at the upper knee, open those, take these, and push them forward like that, pull out the feet. Make sure these aren't straight like that, so you gotta be like this, and they tab into a little hole down where the other half of the tank is, and then you just do the exact same thing right over here with the other one. So yeah, there we go. Yeah, he looks pretty awesome. I don't know if this is exactly movie accurate. He didn't look very much like this. He looked a little bit more like how he did in Revenge of the Fallen in the movie, but he also had chains and stuff. I couldn't see these things up here. I couldn't really even see the front of the truck being part of his chest. I couldn't see these wheels here. I couldn't really see anything. I could see wheels on his feet. I could see these toes. His legs, I'd say, are pretty accurate. I couldn't even see the smokestacks on the back, and definitely not this. You know, it's not very movie accurate, but it's good enough. Now, you take the cape. Actually, before I put his cape on, let me show you the head sculpt here, which you're not going to see too well. You can see half of it is, like, blown to bits. It's an entire big glowing eye, pretty much. You can, like, see through it, kind of see his brains. It's pretty cool. And then, oh, that was his cannon. I meant this thing. Take this and twist it out like that, and you see that hole right there? This thing goes on top and goes in that hole, and make sure that this over here is sticking out, and you can't really see his face right now because of my lighting, but there, it kind of covers up half of his face, the part that's been damaged, and the hand can't really move down here, and if you take this arm and move it off like that, it's going to shift this around because the hole is actually part of the shoulder, which I think is kind of stupid. But now come here and put this right on the... There's a little hole port in there for mech-tech weapons, and he can use his cannon, as seen. Yeah, he's almost too tall for my camera. I've been using deluxes in reviews lately, but there he is, more or less. Looks pretty awesome. I think he looks cool with the cape, but it does limit a lot of posability. I already showed you what happens there. You can't really touch his head. You sort of can go in there and push it up if it needs to be. But I'm going to just take that off. I wanted to show you what he looks like. Just put that aside. His head's on a bone socket joint. The arms, they can go in and out like this, but these things are just going to, like, poke at his head. I don't know why that would be, but the arms can also turn up there, but that's mainly for the transformation. He's got a double-jointed elbow, pretty much, as you can see. The hands will go in and out like that. Yeah, I really love what they did with his hands. I like how they're a bit more humanoid. And then he doesn't turn at the waist, but it turns at the right below the chest. And then the legs will go out that far. Like I said, they're on a double joint, but it's only really for the transformation. And then they'll go pretty far at the knee, and they'll spin right up there. The feet can't do much except that, but that's really just for transformation. So there he is with his posability. Yeah, I really like what they did with the figure. It's just way too small. Yeah, now once again, he has a really awesome weapon here. And I forgot to show you guys, to lock it in place, what you do is push it forward and then turn it that way so that the ladder is like this. And now he's got his claw weapon just pointing out. It looks like a claw weapon, but it could also be like an extended double-barreled cannon. Well, four-barreled cannon. You see there's four of them. So that just looks pretty sweet. And again, he did not have that in the movie. He had a shotgun-type weapon. I don't know if he used any melee, other melees like a sword or anything, but oh well. Now it's cool because you can still give him other weapons like the laser beak weapons, which I think look just awesome on his arms right there, and then on the gun over here. That looks pretty sweet. Or you can also, I forgot to mention this, there's mech tech ports inside those, but in robot mode it's kind of too bad because in robot mode, let's put the other one on here. If you point it up like this, one's going to just fall down because of gravity. So I'd put smaller guns in, like Deluxe Top Spin's little machine guns might work. I don't have him yet, but I'll get him soon. Take him out. Just wanted to show you guys that he can do that. So yeah, there's Voyager Megatron. It's the best Voyager Megatron we've gotten yet from the movie lines. The first one just looked dumb. It was like all icy. He had the worst fingers. The second one was a little better, but he had huge wings.
and he was like green. This one's the best. He really is. I like his weapon. I like the way he transforms. I love his alt mode. He's just way too small. And let me see if I can compare him real quick next to another Voyager, like Voyager Optimus himself. Movie 1 Voyager Optimus, to be exact. Yeah, and as you can see, Voyager Movie 1 Optimus just towers over him. Yeah, this is definitely way out of proportion. He should not be that small. Of course, the Voyagers for the first movie were downsized, for Dark of the Moon were downsized a bit too much. Yeah, this is definitely not a good size comparison. That's why I need to get that other Voyager Optimus, the Battle Blades Optimus. Of course, I think he might be a bit too big compared to him also. But I want that anyways to go in scale with some of the leaders. So yeah, there's Megatron. And let me just put this cape back on just for a final look before the review is done. There we go. There's Voyager Megatron. Can I recommend him? Yeah, sure. We don't have a leader Megatron yet, so you might want to get him if you want a big enough, like, an actual movie 3 Megatron. But, I don't know. You could wait and see if they make a leader. They're more apt to making a leader than they are with Shockwave. Shockwave was so unimportant, I don't think they're even going to make a leader. The Fallen had even more importance than Shockwave, so maybe they'll make a leader Fallen figure someday, but not Shockwave. So hopefully they will do Megatron, though, and that would be good, though, because he was in the movie more, so they would make a leader of him. So let's just keep our fingers crossed. But for right now, we do have this. So yeah, that's my review, guys. Thank you for watching it. Hope you enjoyed it. And this is Optimus Smythe signing off.